Saban guys, we love them, we hate them. They have poetic meaning, they have connections to the user's personality, and some of them are just badass in how they're used within battle. But with many of these, Saban guys become very disappointing ones, and even to the extent of where they're pointless. So in this video, we will be delving into the most pointless Saban guys in Bleach. Now, I'm not going to be including wasted potentials or unexplained Saban guys, because, well, potential doesn't exactly mean pointless. Because if there was potential, it means there could have been and were a lot more to go with that Saban guy than we actually got. It just means, depending on where it was in the story, that would have been explained later on, but because you guys know how it ended, we never actually got that. But we just know it was there. The same thing with unexplained Bankais as well. It would have been fleshed on later on down the story, such as maybe Unohana's, maybe Kisuke's, Kenpachi's, and even Toshiro's to some sort of degree. And we're not counting Bankais that we haven't already seen, because it can't be pointless if we haven't seen it, such as Hisagi's, for example. So I will be explaining Bankais which have had full explanation as well as a showcase. So if there were unexplained Bankais or Bankais that were shown but without any explanation, that will be within a separate video. So let's get right onto it, shall we? So I want to start off with Kensei Maguruma. Kensei's Bankai was a cool design, don't get me wrong, but what did it actually do? Let's summarize what the Bankai was. Tenkan Tachikaze focuses all of its Shikai's form's destructive power into its knuckle blades. As a result, Kensei's punches release an immense explosive force on impact. This explosive power continues to assault its opponents endlessly as long as his fist remains in contact with his opponent. When using this ability, Kensei can change its knuckle blades into brass knuckles as well as spiked gauntlets. Now there's a key factor in there. If Kensei can actually touch his opponent. Because let's be honest, his Shikai could be used more strategical than his Bankai. Because the way I see it, his Bankai should really just be used as a last resort. Because when it released and it actually hits, it's cool as fuck. But it's useless otherwise, because it's not really a Bankai that can be used in many different ways. So let's talk about Soifon as well. Soifon, our little tsundere lesbian. You love her or you hate her, for me personally, I quite like her character. The abilities that she can use, such as Shunko and her ability to use Kido in battle, and her Zanpakuto packing a deadly hit fitting the role of the Stealth Force, kinda gets destroyed by her Bankai ability. Now I totally get it, this is what it's supposed to be. It's supposed to represent the opposite of her position and her ability. And the reason behind her not being the most pointless is because, honestly, I believe this Bankai can be developed. But it's in the list because I don't think it would have been at all. It's just something that I could throw in there to say, yeah, this could be developed. But I feel like throughout the series, it's clean cut, this is what it can do, and this is what it will do, and that's all it is. So what is it really about? Being a ranged weapon of the artillery sort, Jakurai Kuban has the ability to launch the missile attached to its base. To do so, Soifon must first raise and aim the huge missile, using the slits present in her face guard to be able to see what she's doing. Once targeted, small fins extend from numerous points along with the missile before it is fired. It then tracks its target for a precision strike. After a successful hit, the missile creates a powerful and massive explosion, strong enough to crack Tsujuno Saimon. If you didn't know, that's Hachi's Kido ability. The weakness, however, is where it comes into play. Soifon has stated that she can only perform one missile attack because more than one will tax her body. Now again, I could see this actually developing, because if Soifon went and trained a little bit more with this Bankai, she could even eventually go on to fire even more than one shot at a time, even continuously if she really wanted to master it. Again, that's me assuming that it isn't completely mastered already. But as of now, it's pointless. Why? Because it doesn't do anything more than just destructive power. I mean, yeah, sure, it tracks the enemy, but how is this conventional in battle? Unless you use someone like Hachi to help you in this case. When it came to a 1v1 against Barragan, it's pointless. The dude will just age it, rendering it ineffective. Imagine any other opponent. Hitsugaya could just freeze it, Byakuya could just create a Kido wall, or even a Shikai wall. Hell, even Ichigo could use a Getsuga to cut it in half. It's a huge gamble one-hit wonder with nothing else to subsidize it. So I find it pointless in battle and uncreative. Now let's begin to what I believe is the worst.
そうか。使うことにしたんだね。
Ikkaku, Madarame's Ryumon, Hizuki Maru. I can't really give a summary to this because what you see is literally what you get. Ikkaku, when activates his Bankai, is not fully powered. He has to then wake up his own Bankai by attacking or swinging his blade until the little red dragon charges up and then it's more powerful? I would imagine it's talking about destructive capability on how much it can cut or the force each hit can be. But is that it? I mean, presentation, it looks badass as fuck. But what does it do? Is it just a big ass weapon that increases power? Nothing more? And to add insult to injury, it got broken, with Mayuri even stating that it got considerably weaker after having been destroyed by Edrad. So what's the point?
Now that I'd like to see.
I've got just one condition. This attack stays our little secret. Bankai!
Ryumon, Hosoki Maru! Ikkaku Shikai isn't really that great either. It's fragile. It's all down to Ikkaku's fighting style and strategy at this point. It's pretty bland in my eyes, most likely why Kubo never really brought it back up. It's not conventional at this point to fight strong enemies. He might have had a chance in the Karakura Town War arc against that Arrancar, but he really needs to boost his own spiritual pressure to compensate. But that's really just my thoughts on what the most pointless Bankais in Bleach are. If you have any others, then of course tell me in the comment section down below. Again, these are Bankai that we've seen being set in motion and being explained to us fully, and we understand exactly how they are. Of course, Kubo could have thrown extra bits and bobs into the Bankais, but I doubt it would make very much sense and they would be literally shoehorned in there. I would have even threw Komamoras in there to some extent, but again, it did change within the final arc. Same with Hitsugaya's, he's kind of would have been in there as well, but again, he's eventually developed in the final arc too. But if you're asking me about Soifan's or even Ikkaku's or even, you know, Kensei's, I don't really see them being developed that much. I don't see them, you know, having a chance, having an upgrade or having a special ability unlocked to them. I feel like what we see is what we got. Sure, I like the fact that each Bankai has a weakness to it, but these, in this sense, just seemed a bit bland and pointless. So I don't know, am I wrong in this or is there something that I'm missing out from these picks or selections? But of course, you guys tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below. You guys, of course, have this fine day, been handsome, and as always, people, peace out.